Hi, I'm Mike Rifen, the director of Center. The
One.
Hi, welcome to the Center for Global Rifenization. We're here to change the world one song at a time. Now I don't know what to say.
Okay. One.
Hi, I'm Mike Rifen. I'm the director for the Center of Global Rifenization. Or the the Center for Global Rifenization, isn't it? I don't know what welcome. You're here. Welcome to the Outer Limits. Hi, I'm Mike Rifen. Welcome to the Center for Global Rifenization. Our mission here is to change the world one song at a time. I'd encourage you to take a look around the website. Drag your mouse across some of the pictures and so forth, because they're actually hyperlinks to different things. Some good information there. There's some outrageous information. There's some information that's probably not real, for that matter. The ironic times. This sucks, Van Gilder.
See everything you do. Tap your phone, read your mail. They can take your ass straight to jail. Without a charge of a crime, you could be there for a real long time. Your president and your congressman made it easier in 2001. Nobody read it cause there just wasn't time. Fighting terror's new paradigm. Bill of Rights would just never do all the things that they wanted to. Ashcroft sang, let the eagles soar. Bring me the Patriot Act, I want more. Sailed through Congress because of the fear. They were coming to an election year. A pretty good year for the ACLU. Lots of new members and lots of new dudes to help them fight the insanity that happens when a people fail to see. Trading freedom for security is not a deal that they want to see. Patriotic people should never stand for the Patriot Act to be the law of the land.
Let's do that over again.
Story first?
I could do that.
Okay.
Right. When I was a young economics student at Mankato State University, I had a economics professor named Lon Smith. Lon was a real interesting character. He had a resume about as long as my arm here. And among the things that he'd done for work over his lifetime is he'd been a, there's a moth flying around here. He'd been a Catholic priest and been a missionary to Belize, and he eventually married a nun, and apparently the Catholics, they frown on that sort of thing, so he had to move on. And he eventually landed up over at Mankato State University in the economics department, and for some reason I kind of got along with him very well and ended up taking every class that he taught. And one day he walked into class, I think it was a 9 o'clock in the morning class, economics of lesser developed countries, And he started class by saying, if Christ came back today, would he be a Christian? If Marx came back, would he be a Marxist? If Keynes came back, would he be a Keynesian? And Lon's hypothesis, of course, was that no, none of these men would be followers of, because they were all leaders, so then they would never follow a teaching like these followers eventually developed. So that thought in mind, I wrote this for Lon several years later, or with Lon's thoughts in mind.
Christ be a Christian if he came back today? Would he go on the TV and teach us to pray? Would he hang with the Pope and wear a big funny hat, ride around in that white car with the bulletproof glass? Would he have his own website at messiah.com? Would he boot up the scriptures from a DVD-ROM? Would Pat Robertson have him for a guest on his show to raise lots of money, make the 700 Club grow? Would he open a chain store in the back of a mall and sell caps and t-shirts that say forgive them all? Homosexuals, bisexuals too. Would he curse the transgenders like the good Christians do? Except for the Episcopals. Christ was a woman, do you think that she might get crucified again by the religious right? Would Christ be a Christian if she came back today? Would she go on the TV and teach us to pray? Lord, save me from your followers. A boy named Jim. He was a junior at the community pledge you took for abstinence will only go so far. Now she and Jim connected in a way not many do. They partied every afternoon when they got done with school. When she graduated at the top of her class and got a free ride at Purdue, she knew by the end of the summer that she and Jim would be through. And when it's hot and sweaty in the back seat of your boyfriend's car, the pledge you took for abstinence will only go so far. Tried to make that summer special, 'cause they knew it would be their last. But going down to see Dave Matthews Band, they got popped with a pound of crack. The judge said you can join the army or spend 10 years in the pen. So Jim headed off for Basra, and she drove up to Fort Wayne. When it's hot and steamy in the backseat of your boyfriend's car, the pledge you took for abstinence will only go so far. Jim's sister called to tell her about the IED. The striker Jim was riding in was completely blown. Said positive, and then she knew for sure that Jim had left behind something that she was not ready for. And when it's hot and sweaty in the back seat of your boyfriend's car, the pledge you took for abstinence will only go so far. On a Tuesday afternoon, there were protesters that blocked her way, but she finally made it through. After a semester of biology that she took in the fall, she's wondering how abstinence could have made any sense at all. 'Cause when it's hot and steamy in the backseat of your boyfriend's car, the pledge you took for abstinence will only go so far. It'll only go so far. It'll only go so far.
Four, four and two is six. Can't think of any words, so I'm singing arithmetic and I'm waiting for your touch. I got all the time in the world. I love you so much. The first time that I saw you, you didn't seem to care that I thought you were beautiful. I loved your sweet brown hair. Your tongue was sharp and witty, your opinions bold and true. I couldn't help myself, I fell in love with you. I knew we'd get together, so sure as the night is dark. I could see it in your eyes, girl. I could feel that magic spark. And two and two is four, five. 5 and 1 is 6. Can't think of any words, so I'm singing arithmetic and I'm awaiting for your touch. I got all the time in the world. I love you so much. When it happened, when you fell in love with me, it might have been a little bit after an eternity, but I would have waited longer. You were worth the wait. I knew we'd get together, cause I could see that it was fate. We'd end up together laughing, and our hearts would be as one. We'd share each other's laughter, and we'd see the morning sun. 2 and 2 is 4, 5 and 0 is 6. Can't think of any words, so I'm singing arithmetic and I'm waiting for your touch. I got all the time in the world. I love you so much. Future, what do we have in store? Can't tell you about tomorrow, what we are in for, but if it's like the past, I wouldn't be surprised if it's better than we hoped for. Like we really tried to make something special happen, even though we just love each other madly and surrender to the lust. And 2 and 2 is 4, the square root of 36 is 6. Can't think of any words, so I'm singing arithmetic and I'm waiting for your touch. I got all the time in the world. I love you so much. I got all the time in the world. I love you so much.
Start that over again. I was just showing off.
Okay.
You ready?
Yeah.
One.